this will blow your mind. The game of Monopoly, this isn't the game of Monopoly, has been around for 75 years, but it is keeping up with the latest technology with a new FPOS version. Our gadget girl, T. Twyford, is looking at that and... Yes. And will show us how these lovable gadgets of old have actually been zhuzhed up.
Yeah, makeover.
We're going to... T, how are you?
I'm good, Paul. How are you?
We're going to start with the least interesting of these to me, Pokémon.
Well, I suppose it didn't really... It kind of missed my era, I guess, as well.
It missed mine. Which era did it not miss?
I don't know. It's been around for sort of 15 years, the same as Buzz, which seems outrageous. It seems like they're very recent. Pokemon is a computer game brought out by Nintendo.
Yeah.
And I guess, you know...
This is a hard sell for you. Just go quit, because I've lost complete interest already.
All right, basically, it comes with basically the love child of a Tamagotchi and a pedometer.
So and they are so dead, aren't they, the Tamagotchis?
Well, I think this is a great idea because, you know, kids always, you know, they're sitting at home playing computer games, but are they getting out and doing any exercise?
Are they?
No.
A question we always ask ourselves.
Take your Pokewalker and take it out, and every step you take gets you points back in the game.
But hey, the Pokewalker has no legs.
But you do. You know, you put it in your pocket, and as you're walking...
So what is it? It's just a pedometer?
Yeah. With the Tamagotchi kind of put into it, so you get points back in the game.
That is so damn clever, isn't
it? I think it's a great
idea.
They're
going to sell like hotcakes. How much are these?
They are $90 for the game and the Pokewalker.
$90, and it won't take up much room in the bedroom.
No.
All right, fantastic. OK, so Pokemon and also a pedometer. Right, let's talk...
Oh, infinity! And beyond!
And beyond! Look at this. Watch him, right? Watch his arm, because he is equipped with laser power. I'll do it again, if you're not blinded. Wow. And how about this?
Oh,
how
and
about
a little this? Jetpack.
Imagine,
back.
If you will, you've called on Buzz Lightyear to come and help you. He flew right out of shot. Oh, over to Pippa.
Buzz.
He does all kinds. You can.
I think I'm speechless. I think you're selling Buzz completely.
He's better
for
than
me.
A partner. And have a look at his face. Watch this. I have to do the sound for this. Okay. This is so cool.
So, yeah, this is the third reincarnation of Buzz. Toy Story's been around for 15 years, and they're bringing out Toy Story 3, which actually inspired the whole segment today, because they've got a little clip out on YouTube that's got when Barbie met Ken, and it's all very retro, and there's Buzz and Woody, and everyone's in there. So I'm actually really looking forward to Toy Story 3.
15 years. Who, as you said with Pokemon, who would have thought?
Knew?
15 years. I mean, that's extraordinary. Let me load him up, because I know Corin's going to grab him off the desk any minute now. All right, now, how much is he?
He is 90 as well.
See, is that expensive? I don't know.
I don't know, but every single male I've shown that to has
it's so
flown
fantastic.
It around the room. So I think you've...
Every single male you know wants to be Buzz Lightyear.
I think they do.
You know? All right, let's talk Rubik's Cube, because many people would have thought, you know, little square bits of plastic on an elasticated thing that you turn. How clever is that? Well, this is the new one here.
Have you got it?
And this is what it does. And so nothing twists. There are no moving parts.
It's a complete touchscreen Rubik's Cube. So there's no pulling the stickers off like I did. I can remember my one was completely black in the end.
And you can press a button and it'll juggle up. It'll... Yeah. Oh, I don't know. You do it.
I think it looks a bit like a 70s disco.
This is a seriously expensive piece of kit.
It is. The RRP is $300. Fishpond have got it for $180, so you're getting quite a good deal through them. But that's still quite expensive, I guess, for a Rubik's Cube. But if you're a bit of a gadget freak that also likes some Rubik's Cube action.
And probably there'd be a lot of gadget freaks that do like Rubik's Cube. And the thing about
not insinuating anything bad about them.
No, I think it's just outrageously expensive. But having said that...
I think you're having some fun with it in the break.
Yeah, and I can see that people will buy that. The one issue I have with it is the colours are actually quite similar. Like the yellows are not dissimilar to the greens... and some of the blues are lighter than other blues.
We might need to get you tested out for your colours, I think.
Yeah, possibly. All right, this is the king hit now.
Yes.
Monopoly.
Yeah.
This is $70 for the new Monopoly, which I thought, of all of these things, I thought that is a reasonable price.
What's the cheapest?
Yeah. And it's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Is this Monopoly... This is the New Zealand version of Monopoly, but it's zhuzhed up.
It is. I mean, when you pass go, it's $2 million that you get zapped into your account.
Mm-hmm.
You can buy the airport for, I think... Yeah, $2 million again.
But you don't have cash.
No, no cash. We're a cashless society now.
We are.
So you have FPOS machines. Oh, gone a little crazy.
Ignore the Rubik's Cube.
So every player has an FPOS card or a Visa debit card, as they say, and you pop it into the FPOS machine here.
I like it.
Green for money in and red for taking the money out. And you can add millions, thousands.
I like it.
Everything. I think it's great.
Because the most annoying thing about Monopoly is always dealing with the money. Who wants to be the banker? You know,
the bank is the best. this bit?
Well, no, I didn't think so, actually, because...
Under the box.
Yeah, but well, apart from stealing stuff, you don't want to be the banker because it takes your eye off the ball. You want to focus on being a slum landlord. anyway, here's the other thing. Can we look down here? Because this is going to alarm some people. I'll just tip out the things.
Actually, literally.
Sorry about that. I only really wanted to tip out these items here because this is also the updated scenario here. Cell phone, laptop. I hate this. I hate this so much. Cell phone, laptop. Now, there is still the car, surfboard. Who the hell would go around making financial investments on a surfboard except your husband, Pippa? I don't even know what that is. What is that?
Is that a whistle?
It's not a whistle. Pippa will know what that is. And there are two dogs, which is nice. Jandals. I quite like that. And an aeroplane.
And a private jet.
A private jet. A Lear.
That's a really good idea.
That's a good idea. Brilliant. Yep. Thank you very much for that, T.
Thanks.
This is great. And $70 for that Monopoly.
Yep.
What do you think that is, Pippa?
I have no idea what that is. Can you see that? Can you get up
close? Is it a biscuit tin?
It looks like it could be a tin.
Who's going to choose to be a biscuit tin?
It looks like it could be a jar
of something.
Or you
stash all your money in there. I don't know. Symbolic.
I mean, God.
Yeah, it's looking, it looks like it could be a jar of something.
I'll be the car. I'll be the plane. I'll be the biscuit tin.
Yeah. No, you'll tell us
fantastic.
Somewhere, won't it? I would miss the money. I like the money. I like handling the cash. Details of all the toys, of course, are on our nzgirl.co.nz. I'm with the Monopoly. I think that's by far the best.
It is, isn't it?
That Rubik's Cube...
Yeah, I know. I know what you're thinking.